If you've been following the channel for some time, you've probably seen this space from multiple angles already. This is where I spend pretty much my entire day, working on videos, creating courses, commissioned images, working on architecture-related stuff, and learning new things. This video is sponsored by Polycam, a free 3D scanning app with huge potential for streamlining the workflow of architects using just your smartphone. In this video, I'll show you every bit of my studio and current setup, and I'm also going to scan this place in 3D using Polycam. Listen, the new iOS 16 for iPhone just came out, and with it came a feature that I feel will reinvent the architect's profession. It's called Room Mode. Using Polycam, it creates floor plans for you, and the AI identifies what is actually furniture and even what kind of it. I'll talk more about Polycam in a second, as always, timestamps available down below. So I started this YouTube channel when I was still in architecture school. The channel has even changed name since then, and it has only been a year since I moved to this new apartment, and now I've got this entire room dedicated to the upstairs platform. It's an ever-evolving studio where I work both on architecture and content creation. So let me show you around. This room has 15 square meters, a 3x5 meters room. I've got a huge desk here on the right, and I asked the woodworking guy to cut a slit on the back to run all the cables through it. I attached an RGB LED housed in an L-shaped bracket with an acrylic cover on the back, and that is controlled from my phone. I use a laptop with an external monitor, and the laptop is a Concept D7 easel with these specs here. It has pen support, which is pretty cool. A 25-inch ultra-wide monitor, which is kinda old and I've been meaning to upgrade to one with a better color accuracy. The keyboard is wireless and pretty average, and on the mouse, it's a wireless gaming one, you know, for those leisure hours. For content creation, I've got this blue Yeti mic here and a Sony ZV-1 camera. That is also my webcam here on a little magic arm. Everything runs to this USB hub, and although this is kind of messy and I wanted to upgrade to a desktop PC, I like having the flexibility of a laptop, being able to go anywhere with this laptop and work, and especially this one where I can draw in it. Okay, so I'm really excited to show you Polycam because I believe it's a versatile tool for architects. So when they reached out to sponsor the channel, it was really a no-brainer. I only take sponsors that I truly believe will generate value for you guys. The app has three types of scanning. LiDAR mode, which uses the LiDAR sensor. It's made to scan rooms and large spaces. Then room mode, which is the new type of scanning that got released with the iOS 16 update. We'll be able to generate plans and measurements using it. And although other types of scanning can be helpful for architects, it's the room mode I believe will change our workflows. And then third, photo mode, which creates a 3D model using multiple photos. This can generate really high quality models, and this mode is recommended for objects. Now, all modes are available for iPhones with LiDAR, but if you've got an Android or a non-LiDAR device, don't worry, you can still use photo mode. I'm gonna give a quick run through all three of them, and during the video mention the value that it can bring to architects. LiDAR. When you open the app, it goes right to the record screen, but if not, you can click on the plus sign. At the bottom, you can choose which capture mode you want to use. I'm gonna go with LiDAR first, and then here you can toggle between auto and manual. In LiDAR mode, I prefer auto, but feel free to experiment and see for yourself. By the way, Polycam's help section is pretty great. Click on the question mark whenever it appears to get assistance, or even check their learn section on a browser. I'm gonna start recording my studio here, and it's not hard, but there are a few key things you should do to improve your chances of getting a good scan. And also you will see that you will need a couple of tries until you get the hang of it. The first tip I can give you is to plan your capture and have in mind more or less the path you will follow. And then my personal tip here, try not to spend too much time capturing something. I've found that the best results came out when I took my pace to scan everything properly, but results are best if I did not go over a spot too many times. So not that fast, but not that slow either. Somewhere in the middle, but you will see once you have the app on your phone. The mesh up here on the screen is your visual guide. Adjust your pace according to it. And then lastly, the LiDAR won't pick up reflective or transparent surfaces that well. So those areas might appear a little blurry in your final scan. And very detailed and complex surfaces are not ideal for LiDAR. For example, my studio here has too many details and accessories, but it's doable and it will turn out all right, as you will see. It's just that there's modes for each type of scan. So after you finish, you will need to process it. This may take a while depending on the size of your scan, but then which mode you choose now will depend also on the type of your scan. Choose accordingly and hit process, but don't worry, there's the option to change the type of process later on. Okay, once it's processed, you will be able to view it in 3D and do all sorts of things to it. It took me a couple of tries because, as I said, this space has too much stuff, but then you can export it in many different file formats. You can even share it on a link to friends and family to view it on a browser. This is pretty cool. I'll leave my studio's link in the video description if you want to check it out. Now you can see that there's a ruler here. You can take measurements from here or then export it to a 3D software with real dimensions. But the room mode is a lot better to do this if this is your goal. Now this is the mode I'm most excited to tell you guys about. Room mode is Polycam's newest LiDAR powered feature that allows you to create usable models of interior spaces in real time with quicker processing and high accuracy. It's a much quicker workflow, but all the tips I gave you on the LiDAR mode and that I'll give you on the photo mode will apply here as well. The room mode generates a simpler version and separate furniture from walls. This looks quite good already, but then click on floor plan. Come on, and then click on measurements. This is just incredible. I'm yet to test it on a real project, but I'm sure this will make all of that measuring phase at the beginning of every project a lot easier. I don't know about you guys, but back then when I was working in a firm as a junior architect and we had an interior renovation to make, we would go on site, take paper, pencils, tape measures, both electronic and physical, and draw the plan by hand, taking notes, measuring everything, and then later go back to the office and draw it over a drafting software. From this scan, you can export a DXF file that can be imported into all CAD or BIM software out there. I see so much potential in this, and I'll go even further here. With every site visit, you often take a lot of photos to document this space, right? What if you also scan it with LiDAR to thoroughly document this space? It was not that common, but it happened a couple of times. You know, the team go on site, take a bunch of photos to document it, but sometimes they forget that one specific, I don't know, weird drop ceiling with a beam and a wall intersection. You know, with a scan like this, you would have the whole space documented. Okay, back to the studio tour for a second. Let me talk about lighting and plants. Lighting is something that I'm always changing here because I'm always learning new things. But you saw the RGB LED strip on the back of my table. I've also got this sort of picture lamp here controlled from my phone as well. And this one is also RGB. And I custom ordered this neon sign with the upstairs logo. And the coolest thing about it is that this is actually a neon gas sign. The guy I ordered this actually bends the glass and makes it fully by hand. Now over the top shelf here, I've got a mic stand, and then I attached this small LED panel to light me up during calls. It makes a whole lot of difference. It's not something you buy like this. It took me a couple of tries to buy the multiple pieces and put it together. Then on the back shelving system here, I've got another Wi-Fi controlled lamp, but this one is an Edison bulb. For content creation, I've got an Aputure Emeron 100D with a Light Dome Mini 2 and an RGB stick that's pretty handy. I know this is all very technical, but if you're interested in content creation, I'll leave a link in the video description if you want to check out all of this equipment. But also keep in mind that I didn't just buy all of this. It was a slow process of upgrading the gear in parts as the channel grew.
Oh, and then lastly on the lighting topic, a ceiling light. And instead of a neutral temperature, this one is warmer because this studio also functions as a guest room.
Now all the plants that you see here are real, apart from one. I think I've got 6 or 5 at the moment. I'll leave their names on the screen. This window here is huge and there's no direct sunlight here, so it's perfect for these species. Now this one has even given 2 babies already. 3 actually, I already gave one to a friend of mine. I'm kinda into plants, and not for this video, but over my living room, I've got a lot more. Let me show you the photo mode in Polycam by scanning this shelving system here. It works perfectly for single objects as well. In this mode, I like to switch to manual, but the biggest step here is to overlap each photo a bit from the last. Then you go around the object and take as many photos as you feel or necessary, get closer, take from below and all. Imagine that your camera has to see it all. And then, as you might have guessed, you need to process it.
A few minutes later.
And you can use the crop feature here to trim as well. You'll see that it has a lot more details than LiDAR, but it can also get a lot heavier. And keep in mind that the object will be captured with shadows, so a soft and even light is best to avoid harsh shadows. This mode has multiple uses for sure, and I've been thinking how it could have been applied to the architect's profession. One use case, for example, is that if a client has a specific furniture that they want to keep it in the project, they are taking to storage until renovation is completed. So then why not scan it, both to document it, but also possibly to use it in the proposed design render? How cool would that be? And then on the same topic of using Polycam to bring value to the architect's profession, with LiDAR mode, you could use it to design something remotely, for example. Imagine a client is across the world and hires you to renovate their apartment. You could ask them to scan the place, send you all of the info, and in theory, you're good to go. I don't see the scans replacing the good old photo and note-taking, but it can certainly enhance your workflow and give you a lot more data when you go back to the desk to design the space. I hope you got excited as I did about Polycam. I was really looking forward to creating this video and also give you a proper studio tour of this space, because it's something you guys have asked me for some time already. As I told you at the beginning, this is a free app, so there will be a link in the video description for you to learn more about it. It's available both in the App Store and Google Play, and even over the browser. So do you think scans can help architects with some of their tasks? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. And to finalize this video, I think I didn't show you this side here. It has an old wardrobe original from this building. I think it's from the 1960s. And since it often appears on the background, I created a little composition so that every angle was somewhat interesting. I'm not that sure about this composition yet, but it's easy to change. Oh, and there's this couch here, which is actually a mattress with a cover and a couple of cushions. I custom ordered from a stitcher to make it all with the same material so that it would in fact look like a couch. And then there's the rug to damp a bit of the echoes, as well as the pads on the wall here. And obviously my chair, which is just from a local furniture store. And oh, and then this combo here, which is made out of bent plywood to hold a headphone and organize my desk. And there's also this knit organizer here, which is kind of sick, this one. Well, that concludes the tour, and I'll see you in the next videos with tutorials of architectural visualization and representation.